हेलो 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 हेलो, वेलकम टू आवर नेक्स्ट एसे दैट इज एसे 550। एनीवन हु नीड्स दीज नोट्स यू विल फाइंड देम ऑन द टेलीग्राम चैनल, लिंक इज इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन एंड दिस विल बी अ प्योरली इंग्लिश लेक्चर, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। सो 550 टॉक्स अबाउट रिलेटेड पार्टीज। सो फर्स्ट वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट एग्जैक्टली इज अ रिलेटेड पार्टी। सो अ रिलेटेड पार्टी इज अ पर्सन और एन एंटिटी हैविंग कंट्रोल और सिग्निफिकेंट इन्फ्लुएंस ओवर द रिपोर्टिंग एंटिटी। रिपोर्टिंग एंटिटी इज हुज ऑडिट वी आर डूइंग। Second is the entity over which reporting entity has control or significance. So either some party has a control or significant influence on us, or we have a control or significant influence on someone another. And third is our entity under common control with reporting entity via common controlling ownership or common key management. So suppose there are two entities, entity A and entity B, and both of us are controlled by a third entity, that is your entity A. So since both of us are controlled by the same entity, both of us will be related parties. Now what are the auditor's responsibilities? So auditor's general responsibilities is obtain an understanding of related party relations. First you will have to understand that how are my parties related to each other. Second, so how will he do that? That is recognize fraud risk factors as to where fraud can happen. And second is conclude whether financial statements are affected by those relations and the transactions achieved true and fair. You will have to first check that just because I am related, are my transactions, are my financial statements affected by those relationships. And your specific duty, so specific financial reporting framework, established accounting and disclosure requirements. That is, you will have to perform audit procedures to identify, assess and respond to risk of material misstatement. Second is evaluate whether the identified related party relationships and transactions have been appropriately accounted and disclosed. That is my related party relationship, as well as if any transactions that have done within those should be appropriately accounted and disclosed. And third is obtain written representation from TCWG or management. That is your SA 580. Okay, so written representation or 580. So these are your auditor's responsibility, general and specific. Okay, now what are auditor's duties? Yeah, so auditor's duties are, first of all, he will have to do the risk assessment procedure, that is your RAP. So understand the entities, related party relationships and transactions. First he will understand. How will he do this? He will inquire management regarding identifying entities, related parties, the nature of relationships and the type and purpose of transactions with the related party, as to what transactions are we doing. He will identify, account and disclose related party relationships as well as transactions, authorize and approve significant transactions with related party and also outside normal course of business. So what he will do? He will check whether all my related party transactions have been authorized or not, and is there any transaction with my related party that is outside my normal course of business, that is what I usually don't do. If it was a non-related party, I would have not entered into this transaction, but because it is a related party, so I have entered into this transaction, I have done this with them. Then second is maintaining alertness for related party information. That is, he will have to identify instances where management has not disclosed my related party or a related party transaction, but it feels like prima facie seeing the transaction that this might be a related party. So if significant transactions are outside the entity's normal course of business, he will inquire management about the nature of transaction and whether a related party could be involved. Then second is your possible sources of material misstatement. That is, he can identify as to from where he can get possible sources, that is your income tax returns, any internal audit report, any contracts with the management and your shareholders register. That is, if suppose we are entering into transactions with shareholders. Third is your possible sources of identification of related party transactions. That is complex equity transactions, any transactions with offshore entities in jurisdictions with weak corporate laws, sales transactions with usually large discounts. So this is how will you identify that it is a related party transaction. That is, you might see that it is a complex equity transaction, a lot of journal entries passing through one account to another account, transaction in the offshore entity. So you might have a sister concern in a jurisdiction where there are not such strong laws. Any sales transaction where there are unusually large discounts. Okay, so if you are providing large discounts, it is possible that it might be a related party. Okay, now next is identify fraud risk factors. So related party has vetoed significant business decisions taken by management or TCWD. That is, if your related party supports the business decisions taken by management. And next is, if there is no debate among TCWG and management regarding business proposals initiated by RP. That is, if the related party has raised any business proposal, then your TCWG management do not go back and forth as to whether this transaction is right for us, should we enter or not. It straight away just accepts. Okay, so our first point was risk assessment procedures. Our next point is responses to assessed risk. So that is, you will have to respond to the assessed risk. Like once you have only identified the risk is not enough, you will also have to respond appropriately to the risk. So how will you respond to the assessed risk? First is identification of undisclosed related parties or undisclosed related party transactions. So communicate to other members of the engagement team, that is within your audit team, or request management to identify the transaction with the newly identified related parties and inquire management for failure to identify related party or disclose related party. As to, you will ask the management, boss, why did I find this related party? Why didn't you disclose it? Why didn't you show this as a related party transaction? Second is identified significant related party transactions outside normal course of business. Normal course of business, suppose it is a bank. Now the bank lends everybody at, say, suppose 12% interest. But some parties you find that the bank has lent at 4%. Now you will ask, when our normal course, under a normal course of business, we do it at 12%, why is this party at 4%? So that is your outside normal course of business. So you will have to inspect the underlying contract to evaluate business rationale as to the logic behind the business, as to why we are doing. You will collect evidence with respect to approval and authorization of the transaction as to whether this is properly approved and authorized or not. And the last point is assertions that the related party transactions were conducted at arm's length price. So arm's length price is basically fair price. As to whether the transaction that you have done, is this transaction done at a fair price or not. So you will collect sufficient and appropriate audit evidence with respect to management assertions of arm's length transaction and engage expert to determine the market value, because only then you will be able to compare that this is my market value and this is my transaction value. And if both of them are same or even close by each other, you can conclude that they are at arm's length price. Great. So with this we are done with essay 550, and I will see you in the next video, that is essay 560, which talks about subsequent events. So like the video and I'll see you.